Good morning, students. Welcome to our maths class. We were in the page number 80 in exercise 6A, that is name of the chapter ratio and proportion. Okay, all of you open page number 80. Let us see question number 5. Based on ratios, length of a rectangular field given as 100 meters. Length of a rectangular field. That means the shape of our blackboard or the whiteboard is a rectangle shape. We know that fact. Length of a rectangular field is given as 100 meters. Breadth of a rectangular field given as 80 meters. First question, they said us to find ratio between length and breadth. That only I have written. Ratio of length to breadth is equal to 100 is to 80, because length is the first word, so length I have to write first. Breadth is given at last, it is a last word in the sentence, so that breadth value 80 I have written in the second part. That is the order we have to maintain. It's okay, no, students? So length to breadth means 100 is to 80. Last zero cancelled. Then two table used to cancel other part. To 5s are 10, to 4s are 8. 5 and 4 left and no common table is identified. So answer is 5 is to 4. This is only the ratio of length to breadth in the simplified form or in the lowest form. Okay, no? Then second bit in the question 5 only. Perimeter of rectangle we have to find, because they have asked us to find ratio with the help of perimeter also. Ratio we have to identify for the breadth and perimeter, they said. That's why first I have to find perimeter. Perimeter of rectangle formula I have written. 2 of length plus breadth. We have learned already this formula. 2 of length value is 100 and breadth is 80. 2 as it is, 100 plus 80 gives you 180. Then the multiplication gives you 360 meters. It's okay, no? So 2 into 180 is 360 meters. Ratio of breadth to perimeter. Second question is that only. Ratio of breadth to perimeter. Breadth is 80, perimeter is 360. So as for the order I have written, last zero cancelled. Then ninth table I have used, not ninth table, that is fourth table I have used. 4 2s are 8, 4 9s are 36. So 2 and 9 both are left and no common table for them to cancel again. So those two terms will be the answer for us, that 2 is to 9 will be the ratio of the breadth to the perimeter of the rectangle, that is rectangular field. It remains the answer. Okay, students? So this is the procedure through which we can finish it. I hope it is easy for you, because only finding ratios, no? The same way, sixth question is there. It is with mixed fractions given for you. That type of sum I have taught you already in the first question, 9th bit. Question 1, 9th bit, I have taught you with mixed fractions. Same that procedure can be used to do. And the other part, you know how to do that part. Then we'll go for the question number 7. In the same page, 80 only. Question 7, all of you see. See it? The ratio between two quantities given as 3 is to 4. This question 7 is a little different. Till now I did not teach this type of sum. So that let us discuss this part. See this, it is a new model for us. The ratio between two quantities given as 3 is to 4. There are two quantities, it seems. Thus the ratio is given 3 is to 4. First quantity given as 810 rupees. That means first quantity is 3, That is the first quantity given in the form of rupees 810 rupees. Finally, they suggest to find the value of second quantity. Ratio given with a term for the second quantity. The term related to second quantity is 4. But money related to the second quantity they did not give. That is only we have to identify now. We have to find out. It's clear now, students? Let us see. First quantity given is 810 rupees. That is 3 pots. This is 3 pots. That 3 pots is showing first quantity. 3 pots is equal to this first quantity only. That is 810 rupees. 3 pots will be equal to 810 rupees. Is it clear, students? Then we want to find the value of one pot. Then one pot is equal to that 810 by that 3 only. 810 should divide with 3 to get the value of one pot. With cancellation, I have got 270 rupees. That is one pot value I got as 270 rupees. Why should we find one pot value? They did not ask us to find it, but they have asked us to find second quantity, value of second quantity. Second quantity is here, 4 parts are there. If at all we have the one part value with us, we can find 4 parts value. That is only the value of second quantity. That's why we are finding the value of one part. Is it clear now, students? Okay, let us see. Therefore, second quantity is equal to 4 parts. This is the second term given, 4. That means 4 parts are there in the second quantity. 4 into 1 part value which was identified by me, that is 270 rupees. Then if you multiply both of them, 1080 rupees we get. When the first quantity is 810 rupees, then second quantity we got as 1080 rupees. Is it clear now, student? This method of doing is different from the previous methods. That's why I have taught you question 7. This is the procedure through which we can prove this part. I hope this is also very clear for you. Okay now, students, is it very clear for you? Okay now, so it is the procedure we have to use it. I hope things are clear to you. Then with other part of teaching we will teach in the next meter. To complete this, I am sending a photo also for you. Let it complete without missing. You also watch this video. Don't open only photo to copy down in the notebook. Without listening, without learning the procedures, you cannot understand with your classwork also. If you write also classwork, that's why first duty is watching video, then we have to understand it. Only after that we will take the photo to write in your classwork notebook. Don't depend on only photo. You have to depend on the video teaching. Is it clear, student? Take care of it. Thank you, students.